I was always interested with the universe because it's the biggest thing there is, and we're in it. There's a lot of mystery and work to be done there.
There's not a person alive who hasn't looked up at the night sky and thought about where are we and what's our place in all of this.
I'm doing an honors project looking at this time after the beginning of the universe called inflation, where the universe went from being small and hot and dense to expanding exponentially and becoming bigger and colder.
The transition from the end of inflation to the universe we live in is one that's actually really poorly understood. Do primordial black holes exist? What is the nature of dark matter? How was the early universe formed? These are things that we don't have the answer to.
We're looking at a specific model of inflation. It uses two fields that interact with each other. We put our models into the computer and we evolve them over time and see what they produce.
That type of interaction is something that our methods are able to simulate, but it's something that no one's been able to do before. Doing this at Kenyon starts with having people that have the desire to think about these really complicated problems in new ways. And that's something that you get at a liberal arts college because studying physics in this environment makes us better physicists.
I think having to take classes outside of physics has really just made me think about things in different ways. It gives you more than just a physics perspective on the work that you're doing.
We are learning how particles and energy and gravity interact with each other. Something that we're studying now will lead to something that will be really important to everybody in 100 years. We're just not sure which path it's going to take yet. This project is in collaboration with a colleague of mine from MIT and two other colleagues from the Netherlands, experts in trying to attack this problem from an analytic side.
We went to MIT. We were comparing our nonlinear runs to their linear analysis, and we did see the two line up pretty well. That was really exciting. The level of my understanding was a lot deeper than I had anticipated. I think that my 2 years in cosmology prior to that had given me enough baseline that I could keep up with everyone else. I impressed myself. Right now I'm applying to get my PhD in physics. I think a research-based career would be pretty cool. Thinking about these questions and answering them it's very fulfilling.
It really makes me happy to see students turn from students into collaborators. That's something that makes me really proud. I don't see any possible universe in which Rachel and I don't have a publication by the end of the year.